Good morning, dear students. I'm your math teacher. Dear students, today we are going to learn about the new concept length. Dear students, you know what? What is the meaning of length? Yes. So, firstly, length is a term used for identifying the size of an object or distance from one point to length. Is a measure of how long an object is or the distance between two points. Once again, length is a term used for identifying the size of an object or distance from one point to length. Is a measure of how long an object is at the distance between two points. Isn't it? Yes. Dear students, in the class today we are going to learn about length. Firstly, look at the picture now. So here, name the pictures: tree, boy, and then girl, then house. So firstly, near and far. Now you identify the things or object which is a near and which is a far. So firstly, what is the meaning of far? Which is away from us when we see things from long distance, that is called is far. Again, which is away from us when we see things from long distance, that is called what is as far. Look at then, what is the meaning of near? The object that is close to you, that is called near. Which object that is close to you, that is called near. Okay, I hope you understand the what is meaning of near and far. Now let us look at the given above picture, and then there are some questions. Now you answer the question. Okay, who is near the house? So look at here the four kind, different kinds, what is things. One is boy, tree, house, and then girl. Firstly, what is the question? Who is near the house? Where is near? Who is near? Yes, boy or girl? Look at the picture now. Look at the picture. The girl is near the house. The girl is near the house. Then let's we go to the next one. Here, who is far from the house? Who is far from the house? The boy is far from the house. Then who is near the tree? The boy is near the tree. Who is far from the tree? The girl is far from the tree. He standing away from the tree. That's why he standing. He girl, she is what is far from the tree. And then boy is near the tree. Okay, let's move the next one. Yes, dear students, look at first one. Who is far from the house? Who is far from the house? The boy is far from the house. Who is near the tree? A boy is near the tree. Who is far from the tree? The girl is far from the tree. So let's one activity is there. So which is near and which is far? Let us identify the things which is near and then which is far. Look at the pictures and put right mark to the animals which is near the tree. So now you identify the animals which is near the tree and then which is far from the tree. So firstly, here there are two animals. One is rabbit and then other one is dog. So what is the question now? Look at the picture and put a right mark to the animals which is near the tree. So near the tree is Near the tree is, what is this? Rabbit. So, now we put a right mark for the rabbit pictures. Why don't we put a right mark for the dog? Because of dog is far from the tree. That's why here rabbit is near to the tree. That's why we put a right mark to the rabbit picture. Okay. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Here, look at the pictures and circle the one who is sitting far from the blackboard. So here the classroom is. So one girl and then boy. So now you identify circle one who is sitting far from the blackboards. Who is sitting far from the blackboard? Yes, exactly. Here boy is sitting far from the blackboard. So now we circle to the boy picture. Why? Because of he is sitting far from the blackboard. Okay. So girl is near to the blackboard. Okay. Now then third one. Look at the pictures and answer. So here, firstly, here Anaga and then Sita is running. Here, look at, it's a finishing line. So now look at the pictures and answer the following. Which girl is near the finishing line? So Anaga and Sita are running. So which girl is near to the finishing line? Sita? Yes. No, it's wrong. Why? So Anaga is near to the finishing line. Sita is far from finishing line. So here the first one answer is Anaga or Sita? Anaga. So now you write Anaga. A-N-A-G-H-A. Anaga. Okay. So right now A-N-A-G-H-A. Anaga. Okay. The next one. Which girl is far from the finishing line? So remind girl is who are? Yes, Sita. Sita is far from the finishing line. So the second one question, which girl is far from the finishing line? The name of finish, who is she? Sita. Yes. Now you write Sita's name. S-I-T-A. Sita. Okay. Shall we move the next one? Yes, okay. Look at here, dear students, thick and thin. So usually you know which object is thin and then which object is thick. So let's we look at the examples and understand better what is the concept thick and thin. So look at the examples. First one, look at the pair of pictures and identify which is a thin and which is a thick. We compare between two things, we identify easily which is a thing thick and which is a thin. Okay. So here one is this hockey stick, then the other one is bat. You know very well is which is a thick and then which is a thin. So already one is done for you. So here hockey stick is thin, then cricket bat is thick, isn't it? Yes. Shall we move the next one? Yes. The second one is leaf and textbook, isn't it? Yes. Now you identify yourself which one object is thick and then which one object is thin. So here leaf are thick or thin? Yes, definitely leaf are thin. THIN, thin. Then book is thick. THICK, thick. Okay, thick and thin. So leaf is thin, book is thick. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Yes, name the object please. Firstly, which is pumpkin. Then the second one is green chili. So now you identify the which one object is thick and then which one object is thin. So pumpkin is usually it is thick object. So here now you write THICK, thick. Okay, then green chili is thin, THINE, thin. Okay, finish. Shall we move the next one? Yes. So next one is eraser and what is box. So which is a thick and which is a thin? Now you identify yourself. So which one object is thin and which one object is thick? So here firstly it is a thick or thin? Yes, definitely it's a thick object. Then eraser is thin object. What is thin? Okay, yes, like that. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Look at, dear students, mark, write the thin one. So firstly finger and then hand. Now you identify which one is thin object. Just you put a right mark for the thin object. Firstly finger and then hand. So thin object is hand or finger? Yes, obviously finger. It's a thin object. Come to the next one, then mat and then bed. So which one is a thin object? Yes, very good. That is mat. That is a thin object. Mark right the thick one. So here which is the thick one object? Yes, it is a thick one object. Then here compare two things, which one is a thin which one is a thick object, first one or second one? Yes, very good, second one is thick object. Okay, yes. Look at, dear students, long and short. Yes, you compare between two things. What is one is long and then other one is short. Just put a right mark for which one is the long one. Okay, here musical instruments are there. So now you find out yourself and now you identify which is the long one. Okay, firstly here can you find out the long one here? Yes, here is a long one. In the second one it is a long one. In the third one it is a long one. In the fourth one it is a long one. So remains are short. Okay, yes. Write L for long object and S for short object in the box given. So here there are two kinds, same kinds. So now you find out yourself which is a long one and then which is a short one. Okay, so you just write it L for long, S for short. Okay, so firstly first one, trunk is long or short?
Yes, very good. First one, train or long, and the second one, train or short. So that's why we write L for first one, train, S for second one, train. Then come to the next one. Here first one is long and the second one is short. Here the first one is long or short? Yes, it's a short. It's a long. Yes, then the last fourth one. First one, toothpaste is short. Then the second one, toothpaste is long. Okay. Yes. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Here, tall and short. Now you just identify the things. Write T for tall object and S for short object in the box given. So look at the object and compare two objects. Now you identify yourself which is tall and then which is short. So firstly, dear students, you just write T for tall object, you just write S for short object. Firstly, dear students, here first one is tall or short? Tall. Then the second one is short. Here come to the second one picture. It's a tall, it's a short. Okay. In the third one picture is, it is a tall, it is a short. So we write T for tall, S for short. So here first one is tall and the second one is short. Okay, like that. Shall we move the next one? Yes. Look at, dear students, here also same activity. Which one is the tall and then which one is the short? Here you just write S for short, you just write T for tall. So first one building is short, then the second one is tall. Put a write the taller one. So here which one is the taller one? Yes, first one is taller one, then the second one is shorter, isn't it? Yes. Mark write the shorter one. So which is short one? So here there are two vehicles, one is the bus and then other one is car, isn't it? Yes. Firstly, short, we put a right mark for the short one. So which is the short one? Car. Which is the long one? Tall, short one is car, then the long one is bus. Here which is the short one? Yes, candle. Then come to the next one. Which is the short one? Pencil. Okay. Yes, tick right or wrong for the following. So firstly, a giraffe is taller than a rat. Yes, the giraffe is taller than a rat. Yes, right. Your mother is shorter than you? No. A tamarind tree is shorter than a rose plant. A tamarind tree is shorter than a rose plant. It's also wrong. A cow is taller than hen. A cow is taller than hen. It's right. Okay, shall we move the next one example? Yes. Look at high and low. Observe the given picture. Girija and Ambuja are standing at the different places in a building. So here the same building, but here standing
Girija and Ambuja are standing the different places. So now you find out who is standing very high, then who is standing very low. So firstly, here first one, the pink color dress girl is Ambuja. Her name is Ambuja. The blue color girl name is, what is, Girija. Now you find out who is standing very high. Who is standing very high? Yes, here Ambuja is very standing high. So now you write Ambuja's name here, AMBUJA, Ambuja. Then the second one question is, who is standing very low? Who is standing very low? Her name is Girija, isn't it? Yes, Ambuja is standing very high in the building, and then Girija is standing very low at the same building, but they are standing in different places. Okay, then come to the next one. Pick the object which is a high and then which is a low. And tick the object which is low. Firstly, here in this picture, so now you find out the tick the object which is high. Aeroplane or train? Yes, exactly. Aeroplane is high. Aeroplane is flying high, but the train is low level. Okay, then here in the second one picture, tick the object which is low. So tick the object which is low. Bird, tree, house, which is? Yes, very good. House is, house object is very low. Okay, shall we move the next one example? Yes. Look at, dear students, look at these two water cans. So tick the cans in which water level is high. Dear students, here the same water cans, but the water levels are different, isn't it? Yes. So first one water level is high, then the second one water level is low. Now you find out which water can level is high. So firstly, its water can level is high, its water can level is low. So H means high, L means low. Okay, shall we move the next one? Non-standard units of measuring length. So standard unit measurement and non-standard unit measurements. Today, dear students, let's we discuss about non-standard units measurement. So firstly, dear students, look at first one, foot, hand span, foot span, cubit, finger, face, and then fathom. Firstly, dear students, so here look at, it's a foot. What is foot span? We measure the length with the help of foot. It's called as foot span. Then what is this one is hand span. We find the length of any things with the help of hand span, with the help of hand, that is called hand span. Okay, shall we move the next one? What is this? Is cubit. So here it's a cubit measurement. Okay, then this is a pace. What is pace? Then it is forefinger measurement. It is called fathom. What is it? Is called fathom. Shall we move the next one example? Yes. So here look at, dear students, as I told you, foot span, hand span, cubit, fathom, face like that. Okay, it's a non-standard units measurement. In your previous class, you learn how to measure the length using hand span, foot span, and then cubit. Let us learn the some more non-standard ways to measure the length. So look at, dear student, measure with Anaga and her friends were trying to find out the length of the different materials in the classroom. So now you identify the what is non-standard unit measurement. Okay, firstly Anaga and her friend is trying to find out the length of different materials in the classrooms. So firstly, here first one, she measuring the blackboard, isn't it? Yes. She use which one measuring object? Is she use this cubit? What is a fathom? She measure the blackboard by using fathom. Then here duster. What is the non-standard unit measurement? It is a forefinger. Then she tried to find out the length of the table. She used the non-standard unit measurement is hand span. What is hand span? And the fourth one picture is Anaga's friend is what is try to find out the length of the door. So he used the non-standard unit measurement is cubit. Okay, then here in this picture she measuring the classroom length. So which one she measuring the classroom with the help of foot span. Okay, here footstep. In the last one picture, she is measuring the classroom by using footstep or pace. Okay, shall we move the next one? Yes. Look at marble game and gilli dandu. Some children are playing marble in the playground. One child is measuring the length between one marble and another marble. So how is the boy measuring the length in the picture? So look at the picture, dear students. So firstly, some children are playing marble in the playground and one child is measuring the length between one marble to another marble. So how is the boy measuring the length of in the picture? So how is measuring the length of the picture? How is measuring length between one marble to another marble? Yes, look at here, he is measuring the length between one marble to another marbles. He using, so which one non-standard unit measurement? Yes, very good, it's a hand span measuring. Hand span measurement. Yes, okay. Then the boy is measuring the length of using hand span. So in the next one, gilli and dandu. Some children are playing marbles in the playground. So here one boy is measuring the what is dandu with the help of gilli. So which one measurement that is? Yes, that is a hand span measurement. That is hand span measurement. Okay, dear students, then here students, one gilli and dandu. Three gillies are equal to one dandu. Okay, so someone games are what is measuring non-standard units measurement. Okay, then dear students, I hope you understand the concept of what is near, far, and then high and low, thick and thin, long and short, and then high and low, and then non-standard units measurement. Okay, there are what is a hand span, foot span, cubit, fathom, foot, footstep, like that. Okay, in the next class we will learn more about this concept. Okay, thank you dear students.